before we dive in, man, just let everybody know like where you're at right now, what you're doing, and we'll just jump right in.
Yeah, cool. Yeah, I'm teaching high school science in Gastonia, North Carolina, outside of Charlotte. Absolutely love it. It's been good for me. This is my third year. So I worked in industry out of
Yeah.
college. Figured, I didn't love it too much. I find a lot of meaning in teaching. I think that's really important. So I like it. I
Hey,
also like to go back down there.
G knows about the pack. Yeah, fellow Wolfpack brother. So, man, we were talking about this conversation. We've been going back and forth about this conversation for a minute now, and I'm actually super interested because I think this will give a lot of perspective. Actually, my feed gets no exposure from the teaching community, so like this is going to be kind of a really interesting, insight, and we'll pull some tidbits out of this just about it. But to get started, man, like, what is the state of the world in the high school community where you're at right now? What's going on? How are you guys getting through this first couple of weeks?
Well, the first couple of weeks, I mean, the kids are great. I'm happy to be back. I
Yeah.
mean, you got to count your blessings, and to see kids again, I mean, that's huge,
Yeah.
right? I mean, it's what we all signed up to do. So that part, I love it. I love it. But since April, I mean, if
Yeah.
there's one word to sum it up, I mean, it's just indecisiveness, right? So like,
Yeah.
you get the rules from the state government, and unfortunately, they're not clear on a lot of different
For
things.
sure.
So the counties and the districts are, left to fend for themselves. And then, as decision makers aren't always, in tune with the people that are carrying out the decisions, right? And so,
Yeah, no kidding.
indecisiveness is definitely a word, but like I said, we're just happy to be back.
So are you guys in person right now?
So a lot of districts aren't,
Yeah.
but Madison County is doing this weird, I don't know, semi-online thing
Yeah.
where I have half my kids Monday, Tuesday, and the other half are online.
Yeah.
So I teach simultaneously those kids online
For
and
sure.
my in-person kids. And then Wednesday we have a break, which is just, online work. I
Yeah.
Zoom with the kids if they need help, kind of like an office hours or like a
Yeah.
problem session type deal. And
Nice.
then Thursday, Friday, I have the other half of the kids. They switch.
Oh, so it wasn't like you pick whether or not you want to come in. It's like, hey, you get assigned 2 days and then like you're in.
You're right. It's possible. There are some kids that did decide to go all
Yeah.
virtual. But for the school I'm teaching at, it was pretty minimal.
Yeah.
So most of my kids are back. Yeah.
Dude, so I want to know more about this indecisiveness throughout the summer. Like, what were the conversations like with faculty? Like, how were you guys getting information? How were you then interpreting information as a team? Like, what was that like when you're basically trying to figure out what August is going to be?
It was not easy.
Yeah.
There's a lot of rumors and things,
For
and
sure.
like in any industry, I mean, there's a lot of complainers and that sort of thing, which I don't agree with. But yeah, so they put a pause really on everything in March.
Yeah.
And I didn't have a problem with that. Just say, give us 2 weeks, we'll just figuring it out. Because none of us knew what anything was gonna be like.
Yeah.
So I was okay with that. But then when April coming around, it was just like the same type of thing, like nobody's really making a big decision on exactly, what we're going to require from the kids and what we're going to be asked to do and these kind of things.
Yeah.
So we just got through the year. We built the plan as we flew it, as teachers love to say. And then, summer rolled around. I had some professional development over the summer. Some of it was canceled, the normal type stuff.
Yeah.
And we were just waiting. And eventually, August rolled around, and I'm lucky I have a really good boss. So he sent tons of emails.
Yeah.
I'm very lucky to have the boss I have, and kept us in the loop as much as he could. But the way information's disseminated to him, it wasn't,
Really?
timely, and it wasn't comprehensive all the time either. So to answer your question shortly, we didn't know until about the first week before school what was going on.
No
So
kidding. Wow.
yeah. And like I said, some districts were better about it. I love the district I work in, but they just weren't on the ball sometimes.
Yeah.
So we didn't get that information about how we were going to go back with the 2 days on, a day off, 2 days back on, until about a week before school started. So about a week and a half ago, I guess.
So then I assume it's like everybody scrambling to figure out what this new format of learning is going to look like.
And in a, I guess, kind of a negative statement, but it's not what you signed up for as a teacher,
Oh,
right? Like, you
yeah.
love
No,
kids.
I'm, hey, that's real though. This is all real, dude. Like, that's so true.
So, you get the thing, and obviously, you don't take a thankless job and get mad when nobody thanks you. That's ridiculous, right? So I love it. So I wish more teachers had that mentality. But so like the week before school, we were scrambling, right? Yeah. So we had to take a lot of our we had to take a lot of our material that's usually disseminated to the students like day to day and put in more like learning management software, kind of like Moodle that you use in college or like Blackboard or something. Which I guess is a great thing that the high schools are moving towards because it allows for more of a self-paced thing. But well, we can talk about the type of learning styles that, you know, aren't very good at,
you know, not for lots of learning, right? I mean, you're still developing in high school. Like, I mean, shit, you're like going through puberty, like trying to figure out what the world means. And then you got this whole new like scheme of learning coming at you. So like the transition's got to be hard. I mean, for the teachers figuring out what that's going to be like, then the students adapting to it. I mean, I feel like you're going to have a lot of, I mean, I don't, this is all just like me assuming, but like, there's going to be this weird like adjustment period throughout, I don't know, this semester or even like coming out of last semester where people are just trying to figure out what this is going to be like for this level of learning.
You're right. And I mean, that goes for everybody in every walk of life. So we're trying to figure out, you know, the best way to go about our business. And that's happening now. Like this first week, really transitional. You know, I teach higher level classes. I'm blessed to do that. And I couldn't jump right in to, you know. So-